Hi, you guys. Michael DeBar here. You know, I was in this band, The Power Station, and...
The power of the Power Station!
And I wanted to tell you about this new podcast. Now, we all know that there's a tremendous amount of podcasts, but this guy, Joe Kay, he really knows what he's talking about.
Get it on! Got it on! Get it on!
Welcome to listeners, the new listeners, to Joe Kay's new podcast.
So here's a question. What is an easy way for an A-list musical act to make some money without having to do too much work artistically? Record something for a soundtrack, of course. Joe did some soundtrack work in the mid-90s in the midst of the Eagles reunion. And he did it for a property I bet you didn't even realize had a connection to Joe Walsh. See if you recognize this music. Okay, no, Joe Walsh did not write the Robocop theme, obviously. But what he did do was he recorded a soundtrack song for the Robocop TV series. He recorded a duet with Lita Ford. The song was called A Future to This Life, and it played over the end credits of a couple of episodes. So I'm going to play a clip of that now. That was A Future to This Life by Joe Walsh and Lita Ford, recorded for the RoboCop TV series soundtrack. Joe recorded another song on that soundtrack album. One was called Fire and Brimstone, and another one I'll mention is called Guilty of the Crime.
It's a new love story. So read every line. You be the judge and the jury.
Eagles released what I believe is their final album in 2007, an album called Long Road Out of Eden. Joe has a couple of songs there, one called Last Good Time in Town, and a song I mentioned earlier, Guilty of the Crime, which was from that RoboCop soundtrack. The original version is sang by Frankie Miller, and Joe recorded Guilty of the Crime for the Eagles album.
It's a new love story. So read every line. You be the judge and the jury. I'm guilty of the crime.
Besides the single, How Long, from Long Road Out of Eden, I think that's the best song on the record. So one last little anecdote about that duet with Lita Ford. In the book Rock Monster by Kristen Casey, Kristen suggests that Joe and Lita had a little bit of a fling, either before these recording sessions or during. So... that's kind of funny.
In the heart of the dark earth, when the night comes down, you're left with a promise that love will be found. Is anybody out there gonna take your hand?
I've been through an awful lot, decades of playing rock and roll music, and Joe Kay is a wonderful addition to the fabulous world and spectacular world of rock and roll.
The birds in the night.
To do.